Okay, so in this video we are going to learn about operators. So when coding, you will find out that in coding sometimes you need to do some math or some calculations. And with this, we actually use assignment operators, arithmetic operators, and so on. So we already used one operator, and it was the equal sign. So that's up here. So with the equal sign, you can actually assign a value to a certain variable or a certain part of a code. Another one, for example, is plus. Plus is also an operator, or minus, equals, minus, then you have like a multiplication, and so on. So let's say we're gonna do let a is equal 12, let b is equal to 33. So what we can do, a plus b. Let's run this. And as you can see, it actually started to do a calculation because we also do a plus b. We can also do a minus b, a divided by b, and a times b. Let's check this out. So as you can see, it actually starts spitting out calculations. Pretty cool. Another one is double equal. So the double equal sign. And this means when we do a is equal to b. Let's test this out. False. So with this one, you can with this operator, you can actually check if something is true or false. So when we want to do b is equal to a, also false. So as you can see, we checked if b was equal to a. That doesn't work. What we can also do, we can actually return true and false by checking if something is not equal to. So for example, a pound sign equals b. Let's check this out. What it says. True. So this says a is not equal to b. We have another one, and that is a b. I'm not sure what this sign is called in English, but it's like the shift and then the dot button. And this one actually checks if a is greater than b. So in this case, a is 12 and b is 33. And as you can see, a is not greater than b. What you can also do is a is smaller than b. And this is going to be a true, because a is 12 and b is 33. Another one, what you can do, a is greater or equal to b. And what this does, so it checks, is a greater or is it equal to b? So I think that this is going to be a false. It's false. We can also check if a is smaller or equal to b. This is going to be true. Pretty cool. So what this does, we now learned mathematic operators, and we learned comparison operators. So comparison operators are actually used a lot when you want to, we have like, when you send money with a bank, right? So let's say we create two new variables. So let amount to pay is equal to 5,000. Let amount paid equal 5,300. So what we can do, let's say we want to check if an amount, so when the bank, so you send your money to the bank and the bank wants to check if the amount is equal to amount to pay. So what we can do, amount to pay is equal to amount paid. So this is how the bank kind of does it. So check it. False. Okay. But is the amount to pay greater or equal to amount to pay, amount paid? This is true. Or no, wait a second, this is not greater, this is smaller, sorry. So if is it smaller or equal to amount paid? True, so it's smaller. So what we can do, amount paid minus amount to pay, check, is 300. So we need to pay back the 300. So 300 is something that we have to pay back. So this is a little bit how banks do it as well, right? This is really simplified, but this is how it works. If an amount is not equal to, so it's false, do something. And is it greater or equal to, do something else. This is really cool. And this is actually what operators are used for. And this is actually how you give your code stuff to do. So if you want to calculate something, you write these operators. It's really cool, really easy. These are the easiest ones. And yeah, I hope you learned something. I hope you understand a little bit how operators work now, how this affects to coding itself. So we want to be able to check if something is equal, if you want to check if it's not enough, if it's too much, and so on and so on. So in the next video, we are going to talk about functions. And in there, we're actually gonna create some calculating functions using the operators that we learned here. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you learned something. And let's go to the next video.